I'm here with Erica Dewant. Erica, one of the great young thinkers of our time, Thinkers 50, one of the top leaders of the future in terms of influencing thought around the world. You went to undergraduate school at Wharton. You have graduate degrees from Harvard and MIT. I love the work you're doing in connectional intelligence. Now, you said there are three types of connectional intelligence. Can you explain that?
Absolutely. So 10 years ago, Malcolm Gladwell coined this concept of a connector as one of the three types of people that create the rise of social epidemics. And that idea really revolutionized teams across the world, the whole idea of how do we build this connector skill set at work. But in today's era, we're not just connected, as we all know, we're over-connected. The average amount of time we spend on email and meetings online is exponential. And what I found in my research is that in today's world, it's not about being a connector. It's really about how do we connect intelligently with our resources. And what I found was that there are three types of connectors you need to really lead dream teams today. The first type of connector is a thinker. So a thinker is a person that's great at connecting around ideas. They know how to bring together different ideas. They have a lot of curiosity and courage to think in a new way, to bring that devil's advocate approach to a problem. The second type of connector are the enablers. The enablers are people that are the awesome community builders. They know how to bring together all the right people in the room. So they're more of your traditional networking types. And the third type of connector are the connection executors. These are the people that are great at mobilizing. Once you have an idea, once you have the right people, how do you mobilize it and turn it into action? And what I found is that in today's world, it's not just about being the best connector yourself. It's about how do you design a team that leverages your own style? Are you more of a thinker, an enabler, or executor? But create a network and leverage others that have different skill sets than you to really create that value. One of my favorite examples of this is from a woman named Jeannie Pieper. When Jeannie was 4 years old, she had a very rare disease called FOB. She spent 20 years going from doctor to doctor trying to diagnose this illness. She met one doctor who actually had seen 18 patients with this disease. And she decided not just to get treated, but to reach out. She was an enabler to reach out to every single patient and created the first ever knowledge network for patients with this disease.
Wow.
Today, that network is now teaching doctors, medical researchers, university professionals how to diagnose this illness. They funded the first ever medical research before, but it didn't just start with just one person. It was Jeannie saying, I want to do something different, and I have to create a network with different skills, people that have expertise in research, people that are doctors as well, other patients around
She's
the world.
An executor.
Exactly, exactly. And so what I recommend for everyone is to better understand their own style, but to really be mindful of tapping into the diversity of their network and skills that are different than them as they're building and getting big things done.
I love what you're doing. Let me give you my personal reflection on that. I see myself as a thinker and an enabler, although not much of an executor. I don't like to manage anything. And I only have two problems with management. One is I have no ability, but I have even less motivation.
So the
point, though, is, I love what you're saying, is finding people who are great at that.
Yes.
You don't have to do everything.
Exactly.
I like your model because it says nobody's going to do everything.
Yes.
What are you good at? What do you like doing?
Right.
And then find other people who complement your skills.
Exactly. Knowing how to find the answer, how to find the resource is more important than having it yourself. And that's really the quotient in today's world. It's being that dot connector instead of just relying on your acquiring your own knowledge.
You know, one of the great leaders you and I have met is Alan Mulally, who was a CEO of Ford, just a wonderful human being. And Alan had a great sense of what you're talking about because he wasn't an expert.
Right.
He didn't pretend to be an expert.
Yeah.
He helped people connect with experts.
Right.
And that made the big difference.
Yes.
So thank you.
Thank you.